Hey guys, so for the following video, we are going to calculate the volume to the nearest hundredth of the amount of water that we need to fill this pool. So here we have this shape that represents a pool, and we're going to fill this thing with water. Now we want to calculate exactly about how many gallons is it going to take us to fill this thing here. So we're finding volume, right? So a couple of things that we're going to need here is we definitely need to know exactly what shape are we dealing with. That way we know the appropriate formulas to use here. So this is actually called a trapezoidal prism. And I already have the formulas that we need right over here on the board. So volume of this kind of shape here is the area of the face of it times the height. Now the area of our face, that's this shape right here. And that's actually a trapezoid. So what we're going to do is we're going to figure out the area of this piece here, and then we're going to multiply it by the length in order to get the whole volume here. So the volume is going to equal to the area times this height times this length here. So the area of this here is the height over 2, and then we're going to multiply by base 1 plus base 2. And once we get that area there, we will then multiply by the height of our figure here. So let's go ahead and plug into the formula of our trapezoid piece, so our face right here. So we are going to have to look at this just a little bit differently here. This trapezoid is kind of on its side. So kind of, you know, try and picture it turned this way. Because when it comes to this here, the length of this here is actually the height. So the length, the height here. Whereas these sides here, the 2 and the 10, those are our bases of this trapezoid. So the bases represent where you have those right angles. So where it's sitting on the right angle, those are your bases. So for our trapezoid, our bases are going to be the 2 and the 10. And our length, or our height of this, is this 60 inches here. So how we plug into this formula here, so our height is the 60 inches. So I'm going to plug in that 60 over 2. And we're going to multiply that by base 1 plus base 2. It doesn't matter which one's base 1 and which one is base 2 as long as we add them both together. So I'm just going to say that base 1 is the 2 plus base 2, which is our 10. And then we're going to go ahead and multiply this by the height of this prism. So again, if we're picturing our bases being these sides over here, its height would actually go out that way. Its height would actually be this 15 right here, kind of its length from our perspective over here. So we would then take that times 15. So let's do a little bit of simplifying here. We do need to follow some order of operations when we break this down, starting with inside our parentheses. So 2 plus 10 gives us a 12 there. Drop everything else down. We can go ahead and divide out this fraction part that we have in front. 60 divided by 2 is going to give us 30. And then we're going to need to take this 30 times this 12 times this 15. And when we multiply all of that together, we get 5,400 cubic feet. So all of this was to in feet here. And remember that volume is always to the third power. So it says calculate to the nearest 100 gallons the amount of water needed. Well, what we calculated here is in cubic feet. So now what we're going to have to do, now that we have our answer here for the volume, this does represent our volume. The volume of this pool is 5,400 cubic feet. But what they want is they want that calculated to gallons. Notice that's what the problem actually asks for. So always make sure that you are calculating this to the correct measurement that they want. So in order to do this conversion real quick, so what we do is we take our 5,400 cubic feet and we put it over 1. So what we're going to do is we're going to multiply our 5,400 cubic feet by our conversion that says that 1 cubic foot is equal to 7.48 gallons. And what we want to do is we want to make sure that we set this calculation up into the measurement that we want to get rid of. We want to get rid of cubic feet and we want to be left with gallons. So we make sure that the cubic feet are set across from each other in the fractions. That way they can cancel with each other. Remember, when it comes to fractions, what you have in the numerator can cancel out with what you have in the denominator as long as they're the same thing. So cubic feet can cancel with cubic feet. Otherwise, we just need to go ahead and multiply out this fraction. And remember, multiplying fractions is straight across, numerator times numerator, denominator times denominator. So after we multiply this out, 5,400 times the 7.48 is going to give us 40,392. And if we round that to the nearest hundredth, remember that's what our question says, it's going to give us 40,400 gallons total, which is quite a bit of water there. I would hate to have to pay for that water bill. Otherwise, that is it for this video.